I am outlining legislation. The co-sponsor memo will go out today on what I believe is not only a new, but the right approach to budgeting in the state. This is an approach that has just started in Connecticut in the last couple years through the efforts of Representative Diana Urban, and it happened with a Republican governor, so it shows it can happen in a bipartisan way. And it's called results-based budgeting. And let me sort of outline what this means. Obviously, right now, we are in, you know, tough economic times. While we're starting to see some growth in tax revenue and we're starting to see some job growth, but it's clear we still have a long way to go to get our fiscal house in order. And there are various different ways that we can approach trying to get that fiscal house in order and how we can approach budgeting. And I believe a results-based budgeting approach is the right way to go for Pennsylvania, and I think the right way to go for every state in the country. And here's how it works. And it is hard, but it is what we need to do. And that is, you analyze every single state program, every single one. That is hard, but it is the right thing to do. And here's why. You then analyze which ones you get the results you are supposed to get and the ones that you are not getting the results that you are supposed to get. And then you base the funding decisions from that hard work. Let me give you an example. A lot of people say we need to cut everything across the board 10% to balance our budget. I understand where that comes from. People don't want higher taxes and they want to see cuts. But think about your own family. If you have a loss in income or costs are going up, so your money doesn't go as far. My wife and I, we have two young kids. Do we treat our movie budget the same as we treat our grocery budget? The answer is no. You still want to get your kids the protein, milk, cereal, what have you. And maybe that means you see a couple less movies during the year. Or there's a couple, or maybe you do a different type of vacation. You maybe go to a state park as opposed to, you know, Disneyland or Disney World. Because the things that you need to do, the essentials, the things you're getting a bang for your buck for, are the things you don't want to give up on. Well, the same thing should be in our Pennsylvania budget. Think about Pennsylvania as a family. There are some things that might have merit and might be good to do at a time when there's available resources, but in times are tough, maybe you need to cut back on it. Well, at the same time, early education, we all know, not only does that help kids now, but it's actually an investment for our businesses in the future. Why should that be treated the same way as WAMS? If you're cutting everything across the board 10%, basic education is treated the same as WAMS. Does that make any sense? What we need to do is do the hard work that Connecticut is now doing. And that is analyzing every single state program, finding out which ones we're getting results from, which ones we aren't, and the ones we aren't getting results from, either get rid of that program or improve it. And the ones we are getting results from, we continue to fund it, because that's not only helping Pennsylvania today, it's helping Pennsylvania in the future.